Hello, and welcome to the Tom Photo channel. I'm Tom, and I'd like to compare the most commonly used, more affordable Fujifilm kit zoom lenses for you. We're finding the sweet spot for those lenses, and I'll give you the aperture ranges that work best for each lens. I'll also talk about my experience with these lenses. I like Fujifilm, so expect good things. We're comparing these three lenses today, the XC15-45, the XC16-50, and the XF18-55. They're ordered from widest to telephoto, smallest to largest, cheapest to more expensive. These are part of Fujifilm kits, but can also be purchased separately. They all have image stabilization and focusing ring. These lenses are all sharp and pretty wonderful, each with their own specialties. It's been said that Fuji stands out because it doesn't make bad lenses. Generally, you cannot go wrong with Fuji optics. When I started using Fuji, I was certainly quite impressed. So let's get started. The XC15-45 is just about the smallest zoom lens you can get. It's all plastic though, 100%. Weighs next to nothing and is motor driven only. It's been created with travel photography and videography in mind. The motor allowing smoother zoom transitions. The lens has no focal range markings or any buttons. It is fully controlled by the camera body. The 15mm wide angle end of the lens is really nice. If you want wide angle, it makes a world of difference whether you have a 15mm or an 18mm at your disposal. The same 3mm difference at the telephoto end would be unnoticeable. What's quite amazing is this lens's sharpness. It is right up there with the more expensive 18-55 lens and even better than the XC16-50, but could probably top them all at its middle focal range at f-stop 8. A wonderful lens for results, not so fine for handling and build quality. Let's find its lens sweet spot at three focal lengths, wide angle, middle angle and telephoto. The x-axis is f-stop. The y-axis is Laplacian sharpness. I have previously produced a video where I talk about how to measure lens sharpness. The link is below. And I'm not going to repeat this here. Here I'm just reporting the results. So at wide angle, we see a plateau with a wide usable range of 5 to 7. The middle range surprises us with a distinctly best f-stop at 8, the sharpness declining in both directions from it. The telephoto end again has a plateau similar to that of the wide angle. This time it's between 5.6 and 10. Please note that you cannot compare the sharpness values between different focal lengths here because at each focal length you essentially photograph a different image. Also, the center to edge sharpness ratio is a function of focal length. However, from experience I can tell you that at the middle focal range this length is exceptionally sharp, comparable to the corresponding prime lens. The XC16-50 is a very nice lens which does not have a motor, so it's more like the real thing. However, it's all plastic too, including the lens connector, and does not feel overly solid when you hold it in your hand. This, however, should not be confused with image quality. I've taken some wonderful shots of very high quality with it, although in my opinion the images are a bit softer than those taken with the other two lenses. Aperture and image stabilization can only be controlled via camera body. The largest aperture value of this lens is 3.5, just like that of the previous one, a very typical value for this size and price point. The wide angle is still a pretty low value of 16mm, which is nice. One useful feature is its quiet focusing system. It's quieter than the other two lenses. This may come in handy when making videos. Let's look at the sharpness graphs. At the wide angle, we see a funny shape that looks like an experimental error at f-stop around 6. It's not. This tip replicates when you repeat the experiment. The sweet spot is hard to pinpoint precisely, but is somewhere between 7 and 10. At the middle focal length, we are seeing behavior similar to the previous lens. The sweet spot is loud and clear at 5.6. This is a couple of steps to the left compared to the 15 to 45 millimeter lens though. Overall, the best range at this focal length is 5.6 to 8. At the telephoto end, the sweet spot is again not well defined, but we'll say it's between 8 and 9. We are again seeing a dip before the sweet spot, but it is shifted to the right a bit. I don't know what's happening at f equals 10 though, and whether it's a fluke or not. The XF 18-55 is Fuji's flagship among the kit lenses. It's exceptionally well built. Especially the resistance when you turn the zoom feels great, precise and sturdy. It's mostly metal and the lens connector is also metal, so the lens feels heavy and professional. The zoom range is the most common among zoom lenses, however, f-stop max of 2.8 at 18mm makes it one step brighter than most competitors. You can turn on and off both the image stabilization and the aperture control ring with a switch on the lens barrel. Yes, it has a mechanical aperture control ring. What a wonderful thing to have. Here's the sharpness graph for the wide angle. It goes up and down. No matter how carefully I measure the sharpness of this lens, this graph never becomes smooth. There's something about how stuff moves around inside this lens that makes it a different beast at each focal length. The sweet spot occurs at f equals 10. At the middle focal range, we are seeing a clear dip in the graph at about 4.5, suggesting us to avoid this f-stop if you desire maximal sharpness. The sweet spot is again at 10. The telephoto end gives us a graph that's really weird. The dip in the graph seems to be getting more grand with each step in the telephoto direction. At the same time, the shape is smooth and the sweet spot is clearly defined at 10. Again, it's 10. This lens just loves f-stop 10 and it hates 6.5 as you can see from the last graph. So to make it easier for you to remember the key points I made, I'm providing you with this summary table. You can download it from my website if you wish. The link is below. I'm also bringing out the single best aperture for each lens across all focal lengths. The fact that you can do this is itself quite unbelievable in my opinion. However, let me stress one other point that deserves attention when looking at lens sharpness tables. The sharpness makes sense only when you photograph flat images. In reality, you also have to consider the depth of field issue. While smaller aperture may decrease the sharpness of your image, it will increase the depth of field. You will have more objects in focus and the overall image might actually appear sharper. So don't just go by the lens sweet spot. In real life, you will often want to deviate from it. So to summarize, I'm sure you agree that the lenses covered are all different. My opinion is that if you're a Fuji user, then the XF 18-55 is a must-have, mostly because of its build quality, but also because the lens sweet spot is in the small aperture range. To a primarily landscape photographer such as myself, this means that the sweet spot and greater depth of field coincide better, and I can take sharper overall landscape images using a tripod. I sold my XC 16-50 because it became a bit redundant next to the superior XF 18-55. I have also once sold my XC 15-45, but then bought it again because I started missing its lightweight and wide angle, coupled with excellent sharpness in the middle of its focal range. I actually use it quite a bit, especially when weight matters. So thanks so much for listening to me, and I invite you to stay tuned for other episodes on my channel where I talk about photography-related matters. You can download a PDF version of my presentation from my website. The link is below. Have a great day, and I hope to talk to you again soon.